sermon, and as you're about to find out, by seeing and hearing, that I get real excited when it comes to God's Word. God's Word says faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God, so I have no doubt in my mind this is God's promise that you'll be blessed by hearing God's Word. So sit back, get comfortable, whatever you need to do, enjoy the sermon. Amen.
Morning. I think that thing was right by my nostril. I think it still is. I need to read something before I pray. So you might be listening to me today and think, what's wrong with him? Don't turn there. I just want you to read it. Sometimes we don't need to follow in the Word. We just need to listen. I'm going to read out of Ecclesiastes chapter 3. Starting in verse 1. It says, everything has its time. To everything, there is a season. A time for every purpose under heaven. A time to be born. And a time to die. A time to plant, a time to pluck what is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to gain and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to sow. A time to keep silent. And a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time of war, and a time of peace. If you believe God's word, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. I do too. There is times that I love nothing more than to preach God's word. Than to get up here and get filled with the Holy Spirit and just say exactly and proclaim and declare God's word and do it loudly and emphatically in fervent spirit. But there's also a time that I feel very uncomfortable because the Lord is growing. And I say that and I feel led to read that is because today, I feel like it's a time to be careful. A time to be careful with every single mother in this house. And I believe the Lord's saying, especially to us guys, we like to be rough and gruff and tough and all that stuff. But, you know, I see as you get closer to the Lord, He will open your eyes to things you never saw. And He's shown me today the difference between being tough and being tender, and that it's okay to be both. And today, if you wonder why I'm not yelling and hollering and going back and forth like a dog on a chain, it's because as I was thinking about this message, I saw big old rough hands holding a little baby bird and how you would naturally be careful with it. And I believe the Lord wants us to be careful with the mamas today. Because the mamas go through a whole lot. And today we're going to do our best, amen, in Jesus' name, to show you honor while at the same time honoring our Father in heaven. And I believe when God is present, He can do both. Amen. You know, I had some notes here to sometimes the Lord just wants you to put the notes down and just talk. Amen. And I'm just going to go ahead and jump into it at Ephesians chapter 6. Y'all turn there if you would, please. Did I pray? I'm going to stop and pray. You can keep turning there if you want. Father, we thank you for your presence. We thank you that you teach us. You are our teacher. Lord, I thank you that those who belong to you are never out of class. Class is never over when we belong to you, because we're always learning. And Lord, I pray that today there is a special blessing to every mother here. Lord, I would be a fool to think that every mama that showed up today is happy or not nervous or not scared or not worrying about something. Lord, I pray, since you're also the God of our emotions, you said, "Come to me, all you weary and heavy laden, and I'll give you rest." Lord, I pray you give every mama in here rest. Father, we pray for those who didn't even want to come to church because they didn't want an emotional scab to be picked and to remind them about their mother who is no longer here with them. I pray, Lord, that you settle that spirit as well. Father, here locally, nothing's hidden from you, but there is a family who lost their mother. I bet you they value their mother today. I bet they see her worth. Father, can we see the worth of our mothers without a violent act taking place, without her passing? Could you provide wisdom and grace and mercy to a generation that sees it before it's too late? Father, I know to cause you to fully show up, there has to be some repentance. So, Father, we repent and we ask that you forgive us for not treating our mothers the way that we should. And, Lord, we ask from this point forward that you teach us how to treat our mothers in an honoring way, knowing that when we do that, it honors you. Father, we love you. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. You know what I love about Cowboy Church is we don't have to be all cleaned up and pretty up. We just keep going to the one that is. I thank God that I don't have to get in a hurry. I pray every mama in here is mightily blessed today. Not kinda, not because it sounds churchy and the right thing to say. I pray that every mother in here, I pray that Jesus himself shows you how much value you have and how much you're worth. Ephesians 6, chapter 6, verses 1 through 4. The subtitle says, "Children and Parents." I pray the Lord keeps you awake today because he has me talking slow. And if you go to sleep, that means you just needed a nap, so go to sleep. You're not going to offend me. As long as you're here, God is blessing you. Amen. "Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and your mother, which is the first commandment, with a promise that it may be well with you and you may live long on the earth. And you fathers, do not provoke your children to wrath, but bring them up in the training and admonition of the Lord. If you believe God's word, say amen.
Amen.
Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Many people want to tell us today what the right thing to do. The right thing to do is obey your parents. Amen. Matter of fact, that is a sign of the end times when many do not obey their parents. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with the promise that it may be well with you and you may live long on the earth. I went back and I was asking God, I was like, Lord, show me what this means. I hear that scripture, I know it, I remember it, I have it memorized, but what does it mean? And so often when I ask God that, He reminds me, the first thing He adjusts on me is my perspective. You know, our thoughts are not His thoughts, our ways are not His ways. And sometimes He'll bring you all the way back to the beginning, and He says, honor thy father and their mother. What does that mean? Well, first we need to go back to the Ten Commandments when Moses went up on Mount Sinai for 40 days and 40 nights. And when he went up there, the Bible declares that the finger of God wrote on two tablets of stone. And on the fifth commandment, He wrote with His finger, y'all listen to this, the most powerful thing known to creation, God Himself wrote with His finger on tablets of stone, honor, imagine Him writing the H, honor thy father and mother. I love that. It brought me all the way back to see how serious God can be. I love it because sometimes we need to hear it in a way that it is not a suggestion. It's not a recommendation. It's a commandment. He's saying, you'll do this. Amen? That God Himself, who created all things, saw fit that you want to live an abundant life. This world wants to tell you how you're going to die, but God will tell you how you should live. And how you should live is you honor your mother. Amen? Honor her. And I love that when he came down off the mountain and he saw them partying, worshiping a paganistic god, a golden bull. And I love this. You can't tell me Moses wasn't fiery. He threw the tablets of stone on the ground. He had to go right back up and get some more. Anybody ever mess something up? You had a plan. You know what you're going to do, and you come down, and then you're all ready to go, and some circumstance is presented to you, and then you lose your mind. You're like, man, you got to go back up the mountain. Anybody ever done that? It helped me to understand that these are the words of God. This isn't words spoken in church. This isn't coming from a preacher. This is coming from God Himself, the Word of God. God breathed. That means it has life in it, and it will change you. So many relationships are hurting today, but guess what? When we walk and talk and do what the Bible tells us to do, it blesses us. And one of them is to honor your mother. I'm just going to get kind of boring here for a second. But I needed to hear this. Sometimes when you dig deeper into God's Word, it blesses you and it makes you appreciate God in another level because He shows you the richness of His Word. It's not just black ink on white paper. Amen? This is not a normal book. This is the Word of God. It brings life to your life. Amen? In the Greek, what does honor mean? And I believe this is a wonderful reminder because it reminds us what the word actually means. It means to honor, show respect. Show respect. That's a big male thing. Did you know it's a mama thing too? Amen. To show respect to your mother. To give her recognition. To recognize your mother. Amen? Not when she walks in the room, you just kind of say, hey, what's up, mama? Stand up and recognize the woman. Amen. You came from her. Amen? To show her value and her worth. You know, this is where I pray that the mamas show their children a little mercy and grace, which they have. Amen. And And let's just be real, this is so much easier, not easy, y'all don't throw stuff at me. It is easier for a woman or a female to do what I'm about to say. It is a lot harder for a male or a boy to do what I'm about to say. But this day has to go so much further than high-fiving your mama saying, Happy Mama Day. Hey, did my part. Going to the house. You know? It needs to be something straight from the pit of your heart. You want to show her worth? You tell her from the very pit of your heart what she means to you. Where's my mama? Stand up, mama. Thank you for loving me when I was a complete turd. Thank you for not killing me when I had a smart mouth. I saw many times in my life that you could have quit and it had been all right because of what you were going through, but you didn't. Your son's a preacher now. I thank God for you, my mother. I pray when my name comes up in your thoughts, you get happy and not sad or mad. I love you. You know I do. And I pray God blesses you with anything you want today. Amen. I thank y'all for being patient with me. But I have a stepmother too. And I'd ask for Shonda, my stepmom, to stand up. I recognize it's hard to be a stepmother because I see my wife go through it as a stepmom to my son. And I want to say thank you in front of everybody. Again, for being a blessing to me when I was a turd to you, just out of spite because you wasn't my mama and I was being mean. And I ask that you forgive me for that. And I pray that God blesses you. And if the enemy ever comes against you to try to convince you you're not family, you rebuke him in the name of Jesus Christ because you are family. Yeah. Amen. Amen. I have no idea where to go now. Y'all turn to John chapter 2, please. The reason I did that is not to take advantage of my position. It's because the Holy Spirit's saying, you ain't going to get out of this that easy. You ain't going to say it and then not demonstrate it. Thank you, Lord. John chapter 2, starting at verse 1. It says, water turned to wine. It says, on the third day there was a wedding in Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Now both Jesus and his disciples were invited to the wedding. And when they had ran out of wine, the mother of Jesus said to him, they have no wine. Jesus said to her, "Woman, what does your concern have to do with me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to his servants, "Whatever he says to you, do it." Now there were set there 6 water pots of stone, according to the manner of the purification of the Jews, containing 20 or 30 gallons apiece. Jesus said to them, "Fill the water pots with water," and they filled them up to the brim. And he said to them, "Draw some out now and take it to the master of the feast," and they took it. When the master of the feast had tasted the water that was made wine and did not know where it came from, but the servants who had drawn the water knew, the master of the feast called the bridegroom, and he said to him, "Every man at the beginning sets out the good wine, and when the guests have well drunk, then the inferior. You have kept the good wine until now. This beginning of signs Jesus did in Cana of Galilee and manifested his glory, and his disciples believed in him. After this, he went down to Capernaum, he, his mother, his brothers, and his disciples, and they did not stay there many days." If you believe and agree with God's word, say amen.
Amen,
amen. I do too. Right off the bat, I didn't realize this. This is crazy. I used to not try to get the sermon to match the holiday. When I first started as a minister, as a pastor, preacher, I was almost defiant towards that. Maybe it's because I was angry with tradition and all this stuff that was of men and not of God. I wanted to be straight from the Holy Spirit. So even at times, if you'd been here at least 7 years, you would see that just because it's Mother's Day doesn't mean that message is going to match that day. But today, I thank God that He'll grow you and mature you. Raise your hand if God is done with you on the maturing process. Amen. Same with preachers. I thank God that He's growing me up. I thank God that some of y'all come to church 4 or 5 years ago and I'm thinking it's something good, and y'all are sitting there going, "Lord, help that man. He don't even know what he's doing." I thank God for patience, and I thank God for long suffering. I thank God that He will have patience with you, and He will grow you, and He will mature you. But I thank God that it is very biblical and okay to recognize mamas. This is where it's not bad to have a Mother Day message. What is bad is that we should put accent only on today and none of the rest. It's like I did my duty, high five for the year. Now I can go back to doing it. No, we should always honor our mothers. Amen? Amen?
Amen.
Amen. And what I love about this is Jesus' first recorded miracle in the Gospels. He's doing it to honor His mother. Now you get this perspective real quick. Jesus, who is God in the flesh. Jesus, who is God in the flesh. He's now at a wedding feast. I don't want to sound crazy. I don't want y'all to just say, "What did he say?" But y'all listen to this, and may the Lord help us all understand this. But He is the one that wrote on the tablets of stone. It says, "Emmanuel, God with us." Jesus is God in the flesh. He is the one that said it in the beginning, "Honor thy father and thy mother. For this will," what did it say? "For it be well with you." And this is the first commandment with a promise. You pick all 10 commandments. This one is the only one that gives you a promise of long life. This one is the only one that gives you a promise of having a well life in the land. Amen? This is what the Bible declares. And what I love about this is that Jesus' first recorded miracle, mamas, are you listening? He did it to honor His mother. Now, how many of you mothers, you got some kids, and at some point in time, maybe it's right now, you thought this right here, "I can't talk to them, they think they know everything. You can't tell him nothing." I take from the giggles, that's a big amen. Amen. Now y'all imagine this. Jesus is your boy. He's perfect. He did know everything. He was the sinless, spotless Lamb of God in the flesh. Amen. Now the reason I say that is because sometimes on the children's side, not the mama's side, but on the children's side, we seem to think that if we know better, we got a better idea, that gives me justification not to listen to my mama. Jesus, who is God in the flesh, knows better than Mary does. Can we get an amen on that?
He knows more than she does. I don't want to get real wild on you, but He created her. And still, Him knowing all of that, His language, it sounds like He was rough with her, but it wasn't. That's just our misunderstanding of the original language. By His actions, He went like this. God, hello, God in the flesh went, yes, ma'am. Is that not cool? I've never seen it that way. He knows everything. He's sinless. He probably has a better idea on how to handle this. But instead, His mama said, hey, we got a problem. Brings to the next topic. And I'm not a mama. Maybe this part I should be quiet and let my mama come up here and preach this part. But I'm going to try to get this one out. Mamas, don't you ever stop going to your children and asking them for help. I don't know it from a mama's perspective. I know it from a dad's perspective, but it would be hard for me as a dad to go to my children and ask for help because I feel like I should be the strong one. I'm the parent. Matter of fact, I know that to be true because I have spoke with some mamas in counseling stuff. And I was like, well, ask your family. She said, I can't. I'm their mother. Here's on the other flip side of that. Because Mary went and asked Jesus. She knew He could handle it. Amen. She knew He could handle it. On the flip side of that is, children, if you see your mama struggling in something and you know that there might be a pride issue on her wanting to ask for your help, then don't make her ask for help. Just go and fulfill that need that she has. Whoa, did you see all them female amens? I might need to clean some stuff up with my two mamas. Don't make her ask. Just go do it. Amen. It said, Jesus said to her, woman, which if you look at different translations, it says, dear woman, and one of the translations says, mother. We hear woman and we think that that's negative. What does your concern have to do with me? My hour has not yet come. That is not Him being mean, because guess what? That is showing to us children how we honor our mother even if we don't agree, or even if it, you ready? You're not ready to, or it's not time. Literally stopped what He was doing, got up and honored His mother. Amen? Jesus said to her, woman, what does your concern have to do with me? My hour has not yet come. His mother said to the servants, whatever He says to you, do it. She didn't even acknowledge or say what Jesus said back to her. She just looked at the servant and says, whatever He says, do it. Now, this is a little side note. Again, mamas, don't y'all be hating on me. A side note. If you ask your child to do something for you, then let them do it. Don't over-supervise it, amen? Look what Mary did. She said, looked at the servant and said, whatever He tells you to do, do it. And she left. Amen? Amen? Amen. That's for the controlling mamas. Amen. Preach the word. I was really nervous about that part, but we'll go on to the next. Whatever He says to you, do it. You know, that all by itself I preached for 40 years. Whatever Jesus tells you to do, do it. Whatever He's telling you to do, He knows the beginning to the end. Amen. Now there were a set there, 6 water pots of stone, according to the manner of purification of the Jews, containing 20 or 30 gallons apiece. Jesus said to them, fill the water pots with water, and they filled them up to the brim. And He said to them, draw some out now and take it to the master of the feast. And they took it. They're doing exactly what He says. Verse 9, when the master of the feast had tasted the water that was made with wine and did not know where it came from, but the servants who drawn the water knew, the master of the feast called the bridegroom, and he said to him, every man at the beginning sets out the good wine, and when the guests have well drunk, then the inferior. You have kept the good wine until now. Real quick, anybody that's been living longer than 5 minutes knows the process of how you make wine. Amen? There is a maturing process. That process takes time. Amen? Maturing wine takes time before it's ready. Jesus touched something that was water and turned it to wine. Instant maturity. Instant the entire system, the entire aging process was instantaneous. Why do I say that? What's the point of that on Mother's Day? This right here. It doesn't matter, mamas, because we know that mamas tend to worry a lot more. Amen? They tend to be fearful more. They tend to be scared more. They tend to be worriers more. Matthew chapter 6 tells us not to do it. They'll say, I know it says it and proclaim it, but I can't stop from doing it. Amen? Amen? Amen. This is the confidence you should have in Christ. Hand your children over to Christ. Amen? Hand anything you hand to Jesus, He can make the maturing process instantaneous. They can literally go to bed lost, corrupt, vile, crazy, and wake up praising God. That's the Jesus we serve. He can change them instantaneously. Amen? When you start seeing a pattern of children like, I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know if they're ever going to come to the Lord. I don't know if they're ever going to do A, B, and C. I don't know. And you get fearful and you get worried. You need to readjust your perspective of the King you serve. King Jesus can change them instantaneously. You know what? That's why politics is not making me nervous. Because I don't care what happens. Can't nobody run up on the throne of God. If Jesus wants to change somebody's heart, He'll change them. Amen? Nothing can shake Jesus. So mamas, listen. Keep handing your children to Jesus. Keep handing your situation to Jesus. Well, it just takes time. It does take time. But guess what? You give them to the one who holds time in His hands, He'll change it instantaneously. Nothing can stop Jesus. This is what I love about Him. And mamas, every single concern, every single worry, hand it to Jesus and watch Him change it. Amen? I love that. Okay. Lord, help me. Oh, all to Jesus. Okay. Amen. Thank you, Lord. I kept singing, but I don't know all the words. I was praying. This is where I love just to get on my knees before the Lord and just tell Him how much you don't know. Amen? You know, we get before the Lord a lot and tell Him how much we do know and how much we need Him to do A, B, and C. But sometimes we need to get before the Lord and tell Him how much we don't know and how much we need His help. You can never go wrong being too humble before the Lord. Never once will you ever hear in heaven at the throne of God, hold up, that one's way too humble. Amen? Can't do it, won't happen. So I went to the Lord, I said, Lord, how can we honor the mothers at church that would please You and please them? You know what I heard Holy Spirit say? Why don't you go ask the mamas? So I did a survey. Yep. So y'all can't, for the next 10 minutes, you can't get mad at me. This is y'all's words. Now, what mothers answered these? It was birth mothers, stepmothers, and church mothers. The Bible says, do not rebuke an older man, but admonish him like a father, an older woman like a mother. There is women who are in the church today who have no children, not a stepmother, and you are, if you belong to Christ, you are a church mama. What does that mean? That means that you have lived a long life, you have experience, you know God, you know how He operates, and you can pour wisdom, grace, and mercy into a young lady. And they will listen and they will be changed. So there is church mamas. All right. Here we go. Mama number one. Listen to your mother. The question was, how can your children honor you? What's five ways your children can honor you? Listen to your mother when she's talking to you. You can always tell the age of the mom or how old the kids are by her response. Listen to your mother when she's talking to you. Guys, some of y'all want to check out on today's sermon. Especially if you're a husband and a daddy. This is how you can help the children behave that way to her. This is what, all right, she wants some help. She's screaming for help. She's calling for help. She's looking at you all big-eyed. I need a little help. So, guys, can't check out on today's message. All right. Number two, show respect. Number three, be obedient when asked to do something. Number four, showing love by being considerate towards your mother. Number five, making your mother proud by the way you live your life according to God's will. Did you realize you can honor your mother by how you live? You know where she got that? From the Father. It's genetically engineered in her. All right, mama number two. Spending time together as a family. Relax, be still, fishing, movies, park, picnic, etc. Making memories together, having fun. Love on each other. Words of affirmation. Amen. You know, after reading a bunch of these and doing this little survey and studying, this is just bad that it takes so long to see these things. Mamas really don't need that much. They just want you to pay attention to them, respect them, show them value, amen? Words of affirmation, thank you, mama, amen? Number five, cherish me, amen? All right. Fred, I'm listening. It just got quiet. Next, mama, obey me, love me, help me around the house and with younger siblings. Respect my advice. Help take care of me when I'm old. Amen. This is the hearts of a mama. Thank you, Jesus, for our mothers. This mother said, call me or text me. Spend time together. Pray together for each other. Honor the Lord. Words of encouragement, of affirmation. Hugs, kisses, physical love, and action. Guys, if your mama likes that, do it. Amen? Thank you, Lord. This mama... Oh, this is a funny one. To actually hear what I'm saying to them and apply it. To do their chores, homework, etc. without me having to ask you over and over and over. After she handed me all this, she keeps going. She's like, there's only five answers. She added two more just in case she didn't get it. And then... I love mamas. She come back in there and goes... I don't do this action, okay? You're about to see me. This is what she was doing. She goes, can I have mine back? I go, yeah, why? She goes, I was a little upset at my kids when I wrote that down. I want to change it. And then it changed to this. Honor the Lord. I was like, Mama had a moment, which is okay. Thank you, Jesus. Love me, respect me. Number three, I believe will forever burn in my heart. Number three, allow me to mess up. And when I do, forgive me. Amen. Moms aren't super women, amen? They're mamas. They mess up. Let's not beat them up when they mess up. Let's just love them through it. Guess what? Like they did us. Teach me how to be better. Talk to me from your heart. Don't just high-five her and say Happy Mother's Day and throw a flower at her. Say, I did my part. You need to talk to your mama. Live a godly life. Treat your wife as if it were the last day. You know, if you'd have asked me if I knew that, I would say yes. But have you ever read something or heard something and when you see it or read it, it just reminds you? One way I can honor my mom is to treat my wife with respect and love. Amen? Teach your children about Jesus by words and actions. Continue loving me whenever you do or do not say it. Recognize Mother's Day and birthday with a small gesture from your heart. And last one that I have, I'm sure all the mamas in here have your own version. Read the Bible, pray for me, pray with me, say thank you, honor God and your family. Amen? That's from the mamas. I need a little bit more. I need at least 10 men to come up here, please. Up to the front. We want to honor the mothers in church today. And it's a little harder to do this with a big crowd. So, y'all please be patient. And men of the church, if you see that this is not enough men to do this, to get this done, then you come up as needed, okay? A few things before I pray. Guys, all you guys, look up here real quick. At the first service, you know, sometimes we can be efficient. What's the best way to get this accomplished on the short amount of time? You know what? The Lord hit me right between the eyes when I was thinking that way at the first service. He says, why are you in a hurry with a mama? Amen. Quit being in a hurry with her. This is not a time to be efficient. This is a time to honor. So we will not get 6 flowers and then pass them out as we go. You'll get 1 flower, and you'll make sure it's nice and pretty, and you will walk to a mama that's standing up, and you will look her in the eye, because guys are not good at that. But look her in the eye and say, mama, God bless you. Amen? Okay, so y'all get a flower ready? And now I need, please, please, ladies, please, mamas. Again, I'm trying to be tender. I'm trying to be careful. Can all the birth mothers, stepmothers, and church mothers stand up, please? Amen. Y'all don't go yet. While we do this, keep in mind there's also adopting mothers, mourning mothers, mothers who are in mourning because they don't have their children, matriarch mothers. You want an extra special blessing? The oldest, high-ranking mother of your bloodline, she probably needs a little bit more honor. Amen. Alone mothers, mothers who are by themselves now, and also all you mothers in here, I want y'all to listen to this. Lost mothers. Mothers who don't know Jesus. Amen? All right, let me pray. Father, I thank you for teaching us how to honor each other. I thank you, Lord, for honoring the mothers today through us, to let them know how special they really are. Lord, teach us how to do this not just today, but for the rest of our lives. May we not be in such a hurry, and may we slow down when mama is present. Stop what we're doing and recognize her value. Father, as these mothers receive this gift, I pray that they receive your anointing and blessing. Lord, I pray that their prayers are answered as soon as they touch the flower. Lord, you said with man it is impossible, but with God nothing is impossible. And Lord, your word also declared that you did strange miracles through the Apostle Paul. So, Father, do something to this flower that does something to them. And may they immediately recognize that was from your throne. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. All right. Y'all go ahead. Cheryl, you have some music to play while they're passing out the flowers, please. Don't get in a hurry, guys, because the guys will get to like the 6th one and be like, pew, we gotta speed this up. They're in the tray. They're right there. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. The Norton matriarch. Daddy never went. I love you, Mama. Sunday. He
said, that's one thing I'll never do. Sorry. But Mama never gave up. She said, one day you'll be sitting here beside me and you.
Don't get in a hurry, don't get in a hurry.
Her tears falling on her folded hands. So that Easter Sunday, Daddy walked in. That's when I began to understand. When Mama prayed, good things
good song,
happened.
Cheryl.
When Mama prayed, lives were changed. Not much more than 5 foot tall, but mountains big and small crumbled all away when Mama prayed. Seventeen,
sure.
And while I hit the bottle, doing anything I dang well please. Burning down life's highway at full throttle, while Mama burned a candle on her knees. And one night I came home half sober. I saw Mama kneeling in the den. As I listened, she and Jesus talked it over. And I knew my restless days were about to end. 'Cause when Mama prayed, good things happened. When Mama prayed, lives were changed. Not much more than 5 foot tall, but mountains big and small crumbled all away when Mama prayed. It isn't like every one of them got answered, but the times they weren't, it seems to me, were rare. You almost felt sorry for the devil, 'cause heaven knows he didn't have a prayer. When Mama prayed, not much more than 5 foot tall, but mountains big and small crumbled all away when Mama prayed.
It's good.
Crumbled all away.
All right.
When Mama prayed.
Sure. Okay, again, I thank y'all for being patient with me, but y'all bear with me just another few minutes. Trying to see if this is the right thing to do or not. Can all the men get up and get on the sides wall, completely surround the mothers, all the men of the church.
ladies, mamas, y'all listen. I believe the Lord wants us to do this is because He needs you to look around at all these men. And that God is stronger than all these men put together and more. And He is the one that watches after your life and your soul. He's the one that watches over and protects you. Amen? And this is symbolic to what He, how much He values your life. Amen? He wants you comforted. He wants you at peace. He wants you secure. And He wants you safe. And y'all be patient while He teaches us men how to do that. Amen? I'm going to read these last bit of scriptures and then we'll close in prayer. It's John chapter 19, verses 25 through 27. It says, the subtitle, I love this, says, Behold Your Mother. Now there stood by the cross of Jesus, His mother and His mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus therefore saw His mother and the disciple whom He loved standing by, He said to His mother, Woman, behold your son. Then He said to the disciple, Behold your mother. That's exclamation point. And from that hour, the disciple took her to his own home. Now y'all listen to this. I never saw this in my life. Never saw this until here recently. Jesus' ministry started off by honoring His mother. One of the last things He said on the cross, not the last thing, but one of the last things He said on the cross, you want the translation? John, take care of my mama. Wow. Talking about honoring your mother. He started off His ministry honoring His mother. And He ended on the cross telling one of His friends, His disciples, John, take care of my mama. How beautiful is that? Amen? May we all bow our heads, please. Father, I thank You for Your Word. I thank You for Your grace and Your mercy. I thank You, Lord, that You give us all the gift of having a mom. Father, if there's anybody here that doesn't know You as Lord and Savior, I know it would make a whole lot of mamas happy if they accepted You today. What a beautiful treat. What a beautiful way to honor mama than to give your life to Jesus or to recommit your life to Christ. It's real simple. It says if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you shall be saved. You say, Lord, forgive me of my sins. You obviously have to mean it. Say, Lord, forgive me of my sins. Save me today. Be Lord of my life. Father, a special, unique blessing. We ask that You give all the mamas of the church, all the mamas of the church, a blessing that no child could ever give her, but only You. May it come straight from Your throne and not the hand of a child or a man or a woman. Lord, we thank You for today. We thank You for our lives and our mothers. May they all be blessed in Jesus' name. Amen. These flowers that are left over, if you want to come by, mamas, if you have daughters, if you want to give one to your daughter, because the Bible says those are future mamas. Amen. It says, let your older women teach your younger women. So if you see flowers.
Hey guys, thanks again for stopping by the sermon section. I hope you enjoyed the sermon. And I just want you to know you don't have to be in church for the Lord to bless you. He will bless you right where you're sitting or standing right now. And remember that the time of salvation is right now. So if you want to call out to the Lord, you can call out to the Lord right now by yourself, wherever you're at, whatever you're doing. Just remember that God said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. And that's those in Christ Jesus. So I hope you're blessed. I hope you come back to see us. In Jesus' name, may the Lord bless you. Amen.